Everyone, today I'm gonna do a Lebanese Arabic lesson with some ways of expressing your emotions and feelings. So we're gonna do things in a little bit of exaggerated way. So for example, if you're tired, how to say I am very tired. If you're happy, how to say I am very, very happy. So we will increase the dose of our feelings. Before I begin, I want to let you know that the next series of Lebanese Arabic 30-day challenge courses will begin January 10 until February 8. So this time the 30-day Lebanese Arabic challenge will be different. I will be sending pre-recorded lessons to everyone, and we will be catching up throughout the week with Q&A sessions and with recap sessions all throughout the week. So if this is something you're interested in, you can get in touch. I'm going to leave my email address under my video when I finish. Hi Joey. So while I speak here on and when I'm live, it's difficult to type things. So I'm gonna type the phrases and expressions that I use after I finish this lesson, because also Instagram doesn't allow me copy paste things. I tried to copy paste it. Anyways, yalla. So I'm gonna start now. So let's start by saying hungry. I'm hungry. How do we say it? Does anyone know كيف منقول بالعربي باللبناني خصوصا كيف منقول I'm hungry؟ شو؟ Hi Anvil. Hi Nabila. So يلا write it down. كيف منقول I'm hungry؟ Hi Rosie. يلا write down for me كيف منقول I'm hungry. إيه جوعان. But if you're very hungry, you say مخور مخور, like I'm starving. مخور أو مخورة, you say مخور أو مخورة. It's a little bit dark, right? Let me try to put on some light here. Okay, so مخور مخورة, extremely hungry. So جوعان جوعانة. If you can't see them now, it's okay. I'm gonna write them under the video, but make sure you're saying them out loud with me. Okay, so جوعان جوعانة, مخور مخورة, extremely hungry, very hungry. Now if you want to say you are full, like you're not hungry anymore, you say شبعان شبعان if you're using it in the masculine form, and شبعانة if you're using it in the feminine form. شبعان شبعانة. But if you want to say that you are extremely full, like you are stuffed, you can say مفزور مفزور if you're a guy. And in the feminine form, we use مفزورة. So مفزور مفزورة. So if you want to say I'm extremely hungry, you say مخور مخورة. If you want to say I am extremely full, I'm stuffed, you say مفزور مفزورة. You can even use the English adjective full and transform it into Arabic. We can say مفول مفول. Even if you go to a restaurant and it's full, like fully booked, you can say مفول. So even when you eat a lot, you can also say مفول مفول أو مفولة if you're a girl. Okay, so كتير جوعان, we say مخور مخورة. كتير شبعان, يعني very full, you can say مفزور, I'm stuffed, مفزورة, kind of like I'm exploding, or مفول and مفولة. Now, if you are feeling very hot, you say مشوب مشوب. It comes from شوب, which is hot. مشوب if when you are feeling hot. مشوب. In the feminine form, you have to say مشوبة مشوبة. So مشوب and مشوبة. But if you're very, very hot, who remembers this from one of my videos? You say فتصان فتصان. Hi حرية. فتصان, or I miss you guys. فتصان. أبو زوز كيفك. So مشوب, I'm hot. فتصان, like I'm extremely hot. It's so hot. فتصان or فتصانة. But if the weather is hot, you can say فطيس. The weather is hot, you can just say فطيس, like it's very hot. But if you are saying I am feeling hot, you have to say فتصان or فتصانة. So these are three so far. Let's repeat. Extremely hungry, you say مخور مخورة. Say it out loud with me. If you're extremely full, you say مفزور أو مفزورة, or you can also say مفول or مفولة, say them out loud. And if you're extremely hot, feeling hot, you can say فتصان, فتصانة. Kind of you're saying I'm suffocated, فتصان, فتصانة. Now, if you are feeling extremely cold, if you're feeling cold, you can just say بردان, بردان, بردانة. But if you want to say I'm extremely cold, you are saying, you will say I am frozen. You say مجلد. Oh, in my case, I say مجلد, مجلد, مجلد. يعني I am feeling very cold. إجل إلياس. So مجلد, مجلد. I am very cold. Okay. So يلا, let's repeat. جوعان يعني مخور. You say, I'm just gonna say the masculine ones. If you're a girl watching or a woman watching, say them in the feminine. Talk about yourself. Okay. So مخور, extremely hungry. شبعان is when you're full. But if you wanna say I'm stuffed, you say مفزور or مفزورة or مفول أو مفولة. Now, if you are feeling hot, you can say مشوب, but you can also say فتصان, فتصانة, extremely hot. And you can say مجلد, I'm very cold, مجلد, instead of بردين and بردينة. Now, if you are in love, you can say أنا مغروم. You don't need to say the أنا, right? You know that you can remove the personal pronouns. So you can say مغروم, مغروم يعني I am in love. But if you want to say, or in the feminine form, of course, you say مغرومة. But if you want to say, I am totally head over heels in love with someone. Does anyone know it, how we say it? يلا, whoever is Lebanese, type it now. You can say مغروم لشوشتة. مغروم لشوشتة. My friend is typing أكل. Literally, he ate, which means, you know, he are, you know, I don't know even how to say it in English, like, how can I say, he hit the wall or something like that. So you can say, the expression to say like somebody is totally in love is مغروم, أنا مغرومة لشوشتة. لشوشتة, kind of like up to your head. And if you type on Google what's the word شوشة with the تي مربوطة, probably a lot of Lebanese don't even know this. It means like... what's this? A hair, like a bunch of hair, like on top of the head, like the horse, or sometimes even like a rooster or something. Even a man who has like just a little bunch of hair. So basically, the expression comes from there. It's a way to say I'm in love so much, up to my head, up till my hair bunch. Okay, so that's مغروم or مغرومة. لشوشتي with a sh, لشوشتي. My cousin is here, Aline. Yalla, she can write them for you. Whatever I say, try to write it with me. Okay? So that's مغروم لشوشتي. I'm totally in love. If you want to say about someone else who's totally in love, like very much, if it's a guy, you say مغروم لشوشتو until he's up to his head, okay? Or مغرومة, the feminine form, you can say مغرومة لشوشتا or شوشتا. Something like that, okay? So shushta or shushta, but usually we use it about ourselves. مغروم لشوشتة, okay? And now, if you want to say I am happy, just happy, you say أنا مبسوط, مبسوط. And in the feminine form, hi Selju. And you say أنا مبسوطة in the feminine form. Now, if you want to say I'm so, so, so happy, we have an expression for that. We say in Arabic, the world is not fitting me. It's like you are so happy and you become so expanded to the point that there is no place for you in the world, kind of in that sense, the expression. So in that case, we say الدنيا, the world, الدنيا, مش, not. And you can say ساعة, like it fits me, ساعتني. Hi Charlotte. الدنيا مش ساعتني. It doesn't matter if you're a guy or a girl. It's the same expression for both, okay? So I'm extremely happy. I'm so, so, so happy. You say الدنيا مش ساعتني. We can also say أنا معيدة, معيدة in the feminine form. And in the masculine form, you say معيد. I'm so happy. معيد, معيد. It comes from the word عيد. And عيد, you know, it means, you know, celebrations or holiday. So when you say معيد, kind of like you're saying I'm on holidays. I'm so happy. It feels like you're on a holiday or something. So basically, if you want to say I'm so happy, you say معيد or معيد in the feminine form, okay? Instead of just مبسوط or مبسوطة, you can say معيد. You can say معيد in the feminine form, or you can say the world can't fit me, the world can't contain me, الدنيا مش ساعتني. Okay, yala, let's repeat the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, say them with me if you just came in right now. Repeat after me. So if you're hungry, you say جوعان or مخور, extremely hungry, مخور. If you are full, you're gonna say شبعان, which is just like, you know, you are just full. Or you can say مفزور, مفزور, يعني you are stuffed. Or you can also say مفول, مفول, you are full, مفول. If you're so hot, you say مشوب, you're hot, just normal hot. But if you're very hot, you say فتصان, like you're suffocating, فتصان or فتصان. And if you are cold, you can say بردان, هاي علوش. You can just say بردان, but you can also say مجلد, like I'm frozen, or مجلد in the feminine form. If you want to say I am so in love with someone, if you're in love, you can just say مغروم, I am infatuated, مغروم or مغرومة. But if you want to say I'm so in love, like totally fully in love, مغروم لشوشتي, up to my head or something, like fully, totally in love, مغروم لشوشتي. It's a slang, colloquial expression, مغروم لشوشتي. And if you want to say I'm so happy, if you're happy, you just say مبسوط. But if you're so happy, you can say معيد, معيد. In the feminine form, you have to say معيد. It's a shame I can't write, because I have to write them one by one. If I can paste it, I have it copied already, so I could have pasted it, but it's okay. So معيد, I am so happy, like extremely happy. Or you can say the world can't contain me, can't fit me. الدنيا مش ساعتني. الدنيا مش ساعتني. I'm so happy that the world feels so small. The next one is I'm tired. Tired. كيف منقول I'm tired بالعربي باللبناني خصوصا؟ كيف منلفظة؟ منقول تعبين. تعبين. بالمذكر in the masculine. In the feminine, بالمؤنث, منقول تعبانة. تعبانة, just tired, تعبانة. But I told you one time in a previous video that if you're so tired, you can say تلفين, أنا تلفين, or in the feminine form, تلفين, like yeah, you are like extremely tired, so so tired, تلفين or تلفين. تلف بيتفلف, what's the word in English when it's not coming to my head. You know, when you destroy something, like for example, I don't know, maybe some papers that you want to get rid of, and you maybe you put them in that machine that where you cut the papers and you throw them and you destroy them. So it kind of means, yeah, and you are saying I'm destroyed, تلفين or تلفين, like extremely tired. But also you can use two other expressions to say I am yes. It can mean shred. Is not just تلفين. تلفين is when you also يعني أتلف يتلفوا in the standard Arabic is when you damage something on purpose, like you just throw it, damage it. Okay, that's why when you use it as an adjective, تلفين, تلفين, kind of you're saying I'm so destroyed, kind of I'm so tired, تلفين, تلفين. But there are other expressions, two other expressions we can use instead of تعبين, which is I'm tired. One of them is محروق دين. محروق دين. محروق means burned, and دين means religion, and دين means my religion. محروق دين, يعني I am extremely, extremely tired. You're literally saying my religion is burned. Okay, I don't know why we say it, but we just say it. Okay, محروق دين, my religion is burned. It means I'm so tired. محروق دين. But you can also say I am dead of tiredness. ميتة تعب. In my case, I'm saying ميتة because I'm not a guy. If you're a guy, you have to say ميت, dead, I'm dead, ميت. And in my case, ميتة in the feminine form. ميتة, تعب. تعب means tiredness or fatigue. So when you say ميتة تعب, you're saying I'm dead of tiredness or fatigue. ميتة تعب. So تعبين is I'm tired. تلفين, I'm extremely tired. You can also say محروق ديني. You can also say ميت or ميتة تعب. محروق ديني doesn't change whether it's masculine or feminine. Yes, extremely tired, exhausted. Yes, for exhausted, تلفين, محروق ديني, ميتة تعب. Yes. Okay. Now, my cousin just wrote something خالص or خالصة على الآخر. Like finished literally till the end. خالص على الآخر. Look how she wrote it. خالص على الآخر or خالصة على الآخر. I don't personally use it to say I'm tired as a joke when you want to say someone is nuts, totally nuts. يعني خالص على الآخر, he's finished. Kind of like saying, you're saying his brain is finished. Like, you know, he's nuts. Okay? I use it as a joke. خالص على الآخر. He's finished to the max. Okay? خالص على الآخر. Or if it's a girl, you say خالصة على الآخر. خالص على الآخر or خالصة على الآخر. You can also just say خالص, he's finished, or خالصة, she's finished. Or you say to the person directly خالص أنت or خالصة أنت, you're finished. As a way to say, you know, you're nuts, you're doing something stupid. I use it as a joke, you know. Okay, so that's for, we went through تعبين, which is تلفين, which is ميت تعب, and محروق دينا. As I said, I'm going to copy-paste these under the video, but keep saying out loud with me, okay? I'm not going to have time to finish all of them, but let's do a couple more. So there's another one, نعسين. نعسين, يعني I'm sleepy, نعسين, in the feminine form, بالمؤنث, we say نعسين. What's another way of saying I'm so sleepy? We say, I am seeing the world as a bed. يعني, you're so sleepy that all what you can see is a bed. Okay? You can't see anything but a bed. Okay? It's like, a, you know, it's the metaphorical way of saying things. So, what I say, شايفي, literally, I am the seer in the feminine form. If you're a guy, you don't say شايفي. You have to say شايف. شايفي. شايف, keep saying with me, شايف, شايف, a person who sees. So when I say شايف, I'm literally saying I'm the seer, but it translates as I am seeing. It translates as a verb, it's a participle, اسم فاعل. So شايف الدنيا, I am seeing the world. شايف الدنيا تخت, a bed. I'm seeing the world as a bed, which means I am so sleepy. All what I want to see is a bed. All I'm seeing is a bed. All I'm imagining is a bed. Like that. So, شايف الدنيا تخت. Okay? شايف الدنيا تخت. Or, if you're a guy, you say, شايف الدنيا تخت. Or, you can just say, نعسين. نعسين يعني sleepy. How long have I been doing this? شو, guys, any questions so far? Let me just see if anyone has a question before I continue. Just a second. Yalla, let's continue since I'm doing this lesson about emotions. As I said, yalla, I'm gonna type the sentences and expressions. It's not really sentences, it's like sometimes adjectives, sometimes phrases in the comment box. Yalla. The next one is محشور or محشورة. محشور, محشور. Pronounce it with me, يلا. محشور, محشورة. Okay? So when you say محشور or محشورة, you're literally saying I'm squeezed or I'm jammed. And it means like you really, really want to go to the toilet. Okay? محشور, بدي فوت على التواليت. Okay, like maybe you've been wanting to use the toilet for the past 1 hour and just you can't take it anymore. You say محشور, محشورة, بدي فوت على التواليت. Okay, محشور, as I said, can also mean someone who's squeezed, who's in a difficult situation, jammed. Maybe it can translate. Okay, سوري شارلوت، سو يو كان سي محشورة بدي فوت على التواليت. يو كان اوسو سي اي كانت اني مور، يو كان سي محشور مش قادر. Literally you're saying I am not the one who's able, which means I can't anymore. محشور مش قادر، مش قادر or مش قادرة. My cousin just wrote it. Check out how to pronounce it. محشور مش قادر، مش قادر. I can't anymore or مش قادرة in the feminine one. Okay, مش قادرة. Now if you are thirsty. كيف منقول thirsty بالعربي؟ شو؟ كيف منقوله؟ عطشة. Who's gonna write it؟ عطشان. Okay؟ عطشان. Yes، عطشان. Bravo شارلوت. عطشان وبالمؤنث in the feminine form عطشانة. Just like you know when you are thirsty. عطشان. عطشانه. But if you are so thirsty, you can say منشف. منشف it's dried. منشف منشف ريق. ريق is your يعني you're saying my saliva is dried. يعني I have a dry mouth. It means I'm so thirsty. منشف ريق. So either you say عطشان عطشانة or you can say منشف ريقي. You can use it as a verb نشف ريقي, because when you use it as a verb نشف instead of منشف, you're saying kind of my saliva dried, which is the same. But when you say نشف ريقي as a verb, it can also mean a totally different. It can mean as well when you're saying to someone, you're not understanding, I told you 1,000 times not to do it, or I told you 1,000 times to do something, but you're not understanding. يعني I spoke so much to the point my mouth dried out. That's why you're saying to the person, نشف ريقي. You know, like your saliva dried out because you spoke so much and they're not even understanding. But here in this case, if you want to use it instead of like I am thirsty, you can say م with a م منشف ريقي. But you can also say نشف ريقي, عطشان عطشانة. Most of these expressions, by the way, you can use it with the regular adjective, but also you can put next to it the one that's a bit amplified. You can say عطشانة نشف ريقي, for example. Or you can say تعبانة محروق ديني. Okay? Or you can say مشوبة أو فطسانة فطيس, for example. So you can try to use them together. It wouldn't be wrong. Okay? Now, the next one is I am angry. حدا بيعرف كيف منقول I am angry بالعربي؟ يلا, كيف منقول I'm angry بالعربي؟ مع, it starts with a ميم, عين, مع. شو؟ I'm not gonna say it. مين بيعرف شو يعني I'm angry؟ معصب. ايه, ومعصبة بالمؤنث, صح. اوكي, معصب او معصبة. معصب معصبة. I'm angry. But if you want to say I'm so angry, we can have all my many expressions for this. We can even do maybe one lesson just for this. But the ones that I just thought about for now is my head is closed. مسكر, it's closed. مسكر. راسي, راسي يعني head. راسي يعني my head. My head is closed. مسكر راسي. Okay, I have like a okay. So مسكر راسي, مسكر راسي, مسكر راسي. My head is closed. And also sometimes when I use مسكر راسي, it means يعني I'm slow today. Like my maybe somebody's explaining something to me, maybe math or whatever, and I'm not understanding it. Aline wrote it. Just check it out. It's مسكر راسي. يعني I'm not understanding. No, I'm a bit slow. My brain is a bit slow. مسكر راسي. But when you say مسكر راسي or even use it as a verb, سكر راسي, I was very angry. مسكر راسي, it's still now I'm angry. مسكر راسي. You can even say to a person, مسكر راسي منك. From you or of you or منك. Okay, مسكر راسي منك. And we have one that's slang and funny to use. I mean, it's nice when people who are non-native speakers use this, because native speakers will find it cute and they might laugh knowing that you know it. This one, if actually for the first time, I noticed that maybe it comes from the word angry, because we have an expression that says m'angra ma'i, m'angra ma'i. So maybe we took the word angry from English, and we tried to form a participle out of it, and we said m'angra ma'i, with me. It's angered with me, something like that. So it's nice to know. M'angra ma'i, like I'm so angry. M'angra ma'i. Okay, I don't use this one a lot, but I just remembered it. M'angra ma'i, msakkar rasi. Msakkar rasi, you can also say al-akhir, to the maximum. Okay? I have one I just remembered. You can even say it arrived with me until here. Okay, what is it that arrived? I don't know, but yani. You can say wasle, and we always use it in the feminine form with the t marbuta. Wasle ma'i, with me. Wasle ma'i lahon, until here. And you do this while you're saying it. If you say wasle ma'i lahon and you don't do any expressions or gestures, that will make no sense. But if you use it with your hand, wasle ma'i lahon, it's arrived with me until here. It's a way to say I'm so angry. Hi Jacob. Wasli ma'i lahun. I am extremely angry. Okay, so you can say msakkar rasi, my head is closed. M'angra ma'i, I'm angered. M'angra ma'i, or wasli ma'i lahun. Now, I still have three more, and then we can do a quick recap. Okay, so we have khayif, I'm scared. Khayif, and in the feminine form, it's khayfe. Khayif. But if you want to amplify it a little bit and exaggerate, you can say مرعوب, 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 or مرعوبة, يعني I am terrified. I'm horrified, you say? Terrified, okay? مرعوب, مرعوبة. So, خايف, خايف, يعني I'm scared. خايفة بالمؤنث, أو مرعوب. مرعوبة. Yes, it's correct. واصلة معي لهون. It's correct. Right. Check it out, guys. Some people are typing them, which is nice. I'm gonna be able to type them when I finish this live, okay? So again, خايف, I'm scared. خايفة, scared in the feminine form. مرعوب, horrified, terrified. مرعوبة in the feminine form. And we can say I'm sad. كيف نقول I'm sad بالعربي؟ شو مين بيعرف؟ يلا اكتبوها. Write it down. كيف بنقول I'm sad؟ Like that. شو؟ زع؟ زعل؟ شو؟ I'm gonna wait. ايه زعلانة، برافو حرية، so زعلانة. But if you want to say I'm sad, like in a more dramatic way, you can say I didn't find the one that's like I'm extremely sad. I just thought about قلبي مكسور. My heart is broken. قلبي مكسور. My heart is broken. But if anyone is Lebanese here and you remember something, write it down so I can say it. So قلبي مكسور or زعلان or زعلانة. Yeah, this is the only one that's coming to my head for now. زعلان زعلانة. قلبي مكسور. And finally, I just want to use one that is فأس is the state, but if you say مفؤوس, مفؤوسة, it's a nice one. مفؤوس, you're literally saying I'm cracked, you know, like you know when there's a crack on an egg, for example. مفؤوس or مفؤوسة, like yeah, I'm, is it in English? I think you say I'm gutted. Like I'm like low and sad and feeling down. مفؤوس, I'm cracked. مفؤوس, مفؤوسة. But if you just want to say, oh, that's bad, or that's annoying, or that's a shame, or that's sad, you say فأسة. If something happened on the spot, you just say a crack, فأسة. But if you want to say I am sad or I am down, you say مفؤوس, مفؤوسة شوي. A little bit even you can use with it. The final one I'm gonna use, it's not exaggerated, it's a feeling that, you know, sometimes when you have a feeling of fear, you're not scared, but there is something that is making you worried or a little bit panicky, but you don't know why and you don't know how to describe it. You have a bad feeling, basically. You have a bad feeling. You can say قلبي نأزين. نأزين. قلبي, my heart. نأزين. That's the word. And نأزين. Okay, let me explain to you what words we can extract from نأزين. For example, if somebody suddenly scares you, in English you say, you scared me, right? In Arabic, I don't say خوفتني. You scared me literally. You could. I say نأزتني. نأزتني. You know that sudden sharp feeling of fear. نأزتني. I say نأزت as the verb. نأزت plus ne, me. You scared me. نأزتني. نأزتني. Okay. نأزتني. Suddenly somebody scared you. Or you know when suddenly goes, if you go and you just say to a baby like peekaboo or baouse and they got scared. You say نأز in the past. نأز. He suddenly got scared. So نأزين is your state when you're saying like it's my state of being scared or having a fear inside you. So when you say قلبي نأزين, you're not saying your heart suddenly got scared like that, no, but you're just saying you have a bad feeling about something. You just feel a bit scared about a situation that you are worried that the outcome might be bad or something, okay? That would be قلبي نأزين, and this will be my last expression for today. So I just want to say thank you for watching before I review it. I also want to say I run Lebanese Arabic 30-day challenge courses. The next series of courses will begin January 10 and they will finish February 8. There are courses for all levels, from absolute beginners until advanced. All of my courses are Lebanese Arabic courses, which means they are also Levantine. Levantine is the dialect spoken in Lebanon, Jordan, Palestine, and Syria. And Lebanese falls under the category of the Levantine dialect. So if you've always wanted to learn spoken Arabic, maybe this might be your chance. The courses, as I said, are 30-day challenge courses, very, very intensive courses, but this time they will be with some flexibility. So I send you pre-recorded lessons and we catch up throughout the week for 6 hours. And if you have any questions, if you want to recap, you come to these sessions, to as many sessions as you want or as little as you want. Okay, so if you need more information, I'm also gonna leave my email address, and whoever did the course with me, my students, leave a comment under this video when I put it on IGTV, so for people to know what's your opinion. Yalla, let's quickly recap. I'm gonna ask you questions this time. Be quick at writing it, okay? Yalla, كيف منقول جوعان, the exaggerated way of saying it, جوعان, كتير جوعان, كيف منقول كتير جوعان. Yalla, I'm gonna skip it until somebody writes it. كيف منقول كتير جوعان وبالعكس, in the opposite. كيف منقول I'm full, شبعان. كتير جوعان وكتير شبعان. كيف منقولهم? How do we say them? كتير جوعان. يلا, somebody write it, remember. كتير جوعان, كتير شبعان. شو? جوعان is مخو. شو? Yeah, مخور, not مخول. That one sounds a little bit like another word used in Egypt. Okay, so kind of like a little bit like an insult. Okay, so جوعان يعني مخور with a ر. Okay, not with a ل. In Egypt, when they say, I don't think they use مخول, but when they say خول, it means يعني they are using gay, but in an insulting way. There's nothing wrong about being gay, but I mean, they use it in an insulting way. Okay, anyways, so جوعان يعني مخور, extremely, extremely hungry. شبعان يعني just full. And مفزور, yes, مخور, very good. And مفزور would be extremely full or مفول. And مشوب, when you're hot, you can say foot. What's the word for مشوب? Foot. What? I almost said the whole thing. Yalla, think about also the opposite of مشوب as well, right? The extreme of very hot and extreme of very cold. كيف منقولون مشوب يعني foot. شو? I think Instagram is a little bit slow in typing it. So, مشوب يعني I'm gonna say it because a little bit it's a bit slow. مشوب يعني فطسان. بردين يعني مجلد, very cold, congelated or like frozen. مجلد yeah, فطسان. مبسوط happy, you can say معيد, معيد with a dal, معيد يعني extremely happy. Or you can also use the expression the world can't fit me, الدنيا مش ساعدني, الدنيا مش ساعدني. تعبان يعني tired, but you can say تلفان, extremely tired. محروق ديني, I'm extremely tired, literally my religion is burned. Or you can say I'm dead of fatigue. ميت تعب, in the feminine form it's ميت تعب. Sleepy, you can say نعسان, but you can also say I see the world as a bed. شايف الدنيا تخت, in the masculine form. In the feminine form you're gonna say شايف الدنيا تخت, all what I see is a bed basically. If you want to go to the toilet, like you just say I'm squeezed, محشور, محشورة, like if you've been holding your, you know, wanting to go to the toilet, محشور, محشورة. بدي فوت على التواليت. عطشان, thirsty, you can say منشف ريقي, my mouth is dried or my saliva is dried. منشف ريقي يعني I'm extremely thirsty. معصب, angry, you can say مسكر راسي, my head is closed. But you can also use the a gesture with your hand and you say واصلي معي لهون, you're literally saying it has arrived with me until here. Yeah, my cousin just wrote مأزز. مأزز كمان also means extremely cold. مأزز, مأزز, extremely cold. You can for معصب also use the fun way مأنجرة معي. Maybe we took it from the English word angry and we transformed it into Arabic. مأنجرة معي. خايف, I am scared. You can also use مرعوب, horrified. I'm going quick now for those of you who joined because this is just a recap. If you want to use these expressions more and listen to the, like a proper explanation, you have to watch this live again. Then we have, as I said, خايف, مرعوب, زعلان, sad. You can also use قلبي مكسور, my heart is broken. Or if you have like a bad feeling and you're worried about something, you can say قلبي, my heart, نئزين, نئزين. Okay? I think that's it for today. As I said, I'm gonna type these in the video that I'm going to leave as an IGTV. The good thing is that when you're watching the video, you can scroll down and keep your eyes on the words. So the best thing to do is repeat, repeat, repeat. Keep your eyes on the words while you're saying it, because you would be reading, hearing and saying out loud, speaking. So you're using different ways. Ideally, if you sit down and write them as well, your brain retains more information, okay? That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And as I said, if you need any more information about my courses, my 30-day challenge courses, I'm going to leave my email address. Come join us in January. Maybe this would be like a nice resolution for the new year. We begin January 10 and we finish February 8. Thank you so much for watching me on this Sunday evening, and I'm going to see you tomorrow. Bye.